Now that we have the AutoTune installed on our ZX10, we're going to put it up on the dyno and we're going to simulate some road riding conditions. We're going to do this by using the brake to hold it and so we can simulate some different throttle positions, 10, 15%, 20% throttle, and you can see where the AutoTune cells will be populated to match the correct AFR. We will then show you how to accept the changes and then send the map to the unit. Now that you've had your AutoTune system installed, you need to enable it in the software. You can go up to Power Commander Tools, Configure, Features Enables and Input Selections, AutoTune, and Configure. In this screen, we can set up AutoTune based on runtime, meaning it will not start to AutoTune until this time is met in seconds. We can base it on engine temperature, meaning if we check this box, and we type in the value in Fahrenheit, it will not start auto-tuning until this temperature is met. Now this will only work if you have the temperature input of the PC5 connected. If you do not, make sure this box is unchecked. Max enrichment, max alignment, it defaults to 20. As we ship it out, you can set this to up to 50 or minus 50. And what this will do is per session only allows the auto-tune to adjust your map plus or minus 20%. As the map gets better and better, and AutoTune is building it closer and closer to your target AFR, you can set this to a smaller value. Click OK. Make sure AutoTune is enabled. Click OK. And the next step is to set up your target AFR. The majority of our maps come set up with a target AFR map set up already. If you see all zeros in here, that means AutoTune will not be able to turn anything on in any of those cells. So right here, this unit would not AutoTune in these cells. And we do recommend on the majority of sport bikes and Harley units that you do not set up any target AFR values in the 2% column. Most sport bikes, the 5% column up to around 5,000 to 6,000 RPMs. And this is due to the reversion of the exhaust. If you're under a controlled environment, such as on the dyno, you could set up target values in this area and it would work pretty well for you. So this value is what the target AFR is going to set to. We usually go around 13.2 and then a little bit leaner in the cruise range for better fuel economy. Down in the lower right hand corner of the software, you'll see a light here, AutoTune running. This particular light will not be illuminated unless the AutoTune is installed correctly and the bike is running in a cell that has AutoTune target values. So if you were to idle this bike right now, AutoTune running light would not be on because we have zeros in these cells where idle is. As the bike runs and you put it in gear and rev it up and get up to 10%, 15% throttle position and this RPM range, then the light will be illuminated.
So with the bike running on the dyno, you will see the AutoTune light illuminated. Then on the right hand side of the screen, you will see the fuel adjust changing constantly to reach the target AFR value. So after a dyno session, or if you've come back from a ride and you want to view your trim table, you would hit Get Map, click on your trim table, and anywhere that you see values other than zero is where the bike has reached and where the AutoTune has made adjustments. So if you see a zero, there's no adjustments there, which means you either didn't reach that cell or the bike has not been in that cell long enough to make a change. Any values you see are changes that have been done by the AutoTune. If you want to apply these changes to your base fuel map, you simply hit Map Tools and accept all trims. You can also clear the trims here if need be, if for some reason you saw a large value or something that you did not seem to think was correct. So accept all trims, that will take these values and apply them to your base fuel table. Then hit Send Map. And now these have been applied and your trim table is now zeroed and ready for another session.